You can't trust everything you read online, especially when it comes to COVID-19 information. Listen to the experts. Since the start of the pandemic, there's been a lot of opinions about the virus's origin, false cures, and treatment methods, and just in general, conspiracy theories. If a person sharing the information isn't a medical professional, a researcher, or reporter who's been covering COVID, it's a good idea to verify their claims. Take these tweets for example. This one claims that the vaccine is giving people something called VAIDS. And this one claims VAIDS is being disguised as HIV. This one states that the vaccine is giving people HIV and VAIDS. This is pretty serious stuff. But is VAIDS, whatever it is, real? And is there any evidence that the vaccine has been linked to HIV? Time to find out. Is this legit? It's Suna, and welcome back to Is This Legit? If you're new here, we teach you how to fact check claims circulating on social media. Let's get into it. First things first, we have to look into the claim that the vaccine is causing what these Twitter users are calling VAIDS, which supposedly stands for Vaccine Acquired Immunodeficiency Syndrome. I searched VAIDS in Google, which pulled a few trustworthy sources that have already debunked this claim. Here's what they say. First, the AP, or Associated Press. They're a well-known news organization and often a primary source for a lot of news. They reported that VAIDS isn't a real thing. According to the article, not only is VAIDS not a real condition, an immunotherapy expert told the AP that COVID-19 vaccines don't cause any immune deficiency syndromes that even match that description. In reality, the COVID-19 vaccine boosts the immune response. The term was coined by a blogger identified as Jack, who wrote, "Sometimes a situation calls for the creation of a brand new term." The blogger defined their made-up syndrome as the gradual destruction of the human immune system by vaccines. So clearly, this Jack person is not a source when it comes to health information. But let's see what some other sources are saying. I turned to this article from Reuters, an international news organization. They interviewed Dr. Stefan Gluckman, a professor who has specialized in infectious diseases. He said VAIDS is absolutely not real and went on to say that there is no evidence that COVID-19 vaccines cause any immunodeficiencies. As for the claim that the vaccine is causing HIV, this has also been widely debunked. According to this fact check from US Today, public health experts have said that the data does not show any link between the shot and cancer or the shot in HIV. US Today talked to Donald Alcindor, an assistant professor of cancer biology at Mehar Medical College, and he said more than 6 billion people have received the COVID vaccine around the world, and incidents of cancer, HIV transmission have not been reported as a causal link to the vaccine. But why can we trust sources like AP, Reuters, and US Today? For one, they did all the hard work of interviewing legitimate experts for their article. Two, they did reporting themselves and didn't attribute everything to another organization. And three, they hyperlinked evidence to the FDA. If you come across an article that doesn't have hyperlinks at all, that's a major red flag. But before we get into our rating, let's see what some other expert primary sources are saying. Heading over to the Center for Disease Control and Prevention's website. While they do have a page on what to know about HIV and the COVID-19 vaccine, it just gives medical suggestions for people who have HIV and are considering getting the COVID vaccine. The page in no way suggests that the vaccine could cause HIV or similar immunocompromising disease. And now for our rating. This should not come as a surprise. We're rating this claim that COVID-19 vaccine causes VAIDS or HIV as not legit. VAIDS is not a real thing. There is absolutely no evidence supporting the claim that the vaccine causes HIV. Remember, it's never a good idea to get your medical advice from random people on Twitter. Consult your doctor and health experts. Thank you for watching, and be sure to subscribe and follow us across all social media platforms. See you next time. Don't compromise.